Hello and welcome one and all back to the exciting world of Fez. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. Today, we're jumping back in. It's actually been quite some time for me. Not as much time for you guys. You saw an episode of Fez more recently, but I went a lot of trips since the last time I recorded Fez. So it's been... Oh, look at the guy's happy face on the side of the wall! I need to find out where the... the alphabet is. There's actually a way to read the alphabet, and I know somebody sent it to me, but I'm determined to find it in the game. I don't have any sneaking suspicion of where it could be, but perhaps if I find it, I may look that up for the next episode, or at least look up the location of it, and then kind of like figure it out myself, because that's the whole point of this, is like figuring everything out myself, right? And because everything is basically. You're capable of figuring out all of the secrets in the game. Oh, God. That's right. This changes the perspective on my ass. I don't know where we are at here. Let's take a look at the map. Last time we did all the sewer stuff, and we teleported back to this little hub here. We've already got one thing, but there's plenty of other stuff to do here, including this location, which has a ton of stuff in it, including a secret passage and cube bits and something else. So we will see if there's anything crazy in here. Also, I didn't mention it before, but the owls that you see throughout the game, there are owls, that come out at night sometimes, I think, and they kind of have some secrets of their own, but I'm not entirely sure what's up with all that. Let's see, what does this do? Oh, that turns that around, okay. Is that gonna help me get anywhere? I mean... Not particularly. Oh, but it will help me get over there. Yeah, there we go. Then I can get this little cube. Like I said, it's been a little while since I played Fez, so getting back into the swing of things and remembering what I did is going to be a little bit more difficult. It actually is not going to be so bad because I have to edit the videos too, so I've actually seen them more than once. So it actually may help me out because then I can kind of remember what I've already done. What are we trying to do here? Oh, not that, that's for sure. I was trying to grab onto the ledge up there. But I think what we're supposed to do is connect them and make a bridge! Da-da-da! See, like this. We'll push this one instead, it'll go the other way. See, look, I made a bridge! A drawbridge! There's, I don't know if I ever talked about it on camera, but you know the bit that we did with the giant clock, the giant metal clock? One of those is actually... one of those cubes that you get there is only achievable once a week. So I'm going to have to try and... Hey, look, there's an owl. Let's talk to the owl. Because the owls, they say stuff, don't they? They give me secrets. Hello, Mr. Owl. Give me secrets. Give me secrets, owl. No? No? No secrets? See, like, the owls, they're in three dimensions. Oh, actually, all of the animals are in three dimensions somehow. That's weird. I guess all of the people are, too, aren't they? They just don't realize that they're being turned by my unlimited powers. I don't have a key, unfortunately. Is that the only other room here? No, there's another room off this place, so we'll find that one first, and we'll go there instead. Is it on any one of these sides here? Yeah, here it is. And I'm sure there'll be a key in here. That's how that works, right? The exploration is strong with this one. I'm glad that I'm finally playing a game again that I get to explore and hang out in, because I feel like the last time that I really played a 2D game that I got to actually explore in and have fun with that was Metroid Fusion, that I did a Let's Play of, like, years ago. That was such a great Let's Play, and, I was reminiscing on old Let's Plays recently because I was going back and looking at them. There's a lot of them that are that have age restrictions on them, which a lot of people have mentioned to me. Unfortunately, there's not a whole lot that I can do about age-restricted videos, only because, I don't really have any control over what YouTube thinks is age-restricted. And unfortunately, just some of my older Let's Plays got that treatment, even though I don't think it's completely fair. What am I supposed to be doing here? Let me see here. There's a door on the backside of that, but there's two little cubey cubes up top there, and I need to figure out how to get them. Oh, there's a hole in the back there that I didn't actually see. So let's go there instead. I just gotta turn this the other way. And then flip the camera around and... Ooh! Oh, hey! There's actually a cube inside of there. And then... am I able to go in the background there, or am I gonna have to figure out a different way to get up there? I guess I'll have to figure out a different way to get up there. Let's see if we can't get over. See if we can't get over to that other side. Somehow I don't think we will. Oh, actually, wait a minute. There is. Oh. I wonder if I do that way. Line these up so that I can get. Oh yeah! Line those up so I can go all the way through. That's cool. That's neat. I'm okay with this. Ta-da! And then dip, dip. And then ta-da! Oh man, 2D perspective, man. It's crazy. It's crazy. Oh, and we completed another cube, which brings us one step closer. How many does that have? How many do we have? 16 and 12? That's what? 20... 28? So... We only have, what, there's 32 cubes in the to 100% the game. There's actually, I found out there's actually more than 100%. There's like 201 point something percent, 68% or something like that. Wait, is this the door that takes us back? Because there's another door up there. No, we started down bottom, so let's go down here. I actually need to get to that other door up top before going anywhere else anyway, ultimately, but we'll go back to it in a second. And we'll just explore around. I'm just satisfied that I'm not, like, doing any crazy things to try and find, dark cubes. Oh, wait a minute. There are shadows of cubes on this place that looks like there might be tunnels or something. Or maybe something hidden inside this place. Or maybe, oh, actually, no, never mind. I was like, why are there weird shadows on this thing? And I realized it's because there's weird square clouds in the sky casting a shadow on the block here. I didn't notice that before. That's kind of interesting. What? Oh, wait a minute. This is going to do a thing, right? There's going to be, like, a hidden hole, a hidden hidey hole. No, don't go the other way. Go this way. There's got to be a hidden hidey hole somewhere here. That unlocks the secret of the cube. I mean, that's one thing. I don't know if that helps me out at all. Let's see. No, that doesn't really help me out at all. I don't know why I thought that would help me. But that's one step closer to science. Let's try on this side. This is the only other side. No, we did all four sides, I think. And there doesn't appear to be anything other than that brick wall down there. I don't exactly see how to get up there. I mean, there is a door there, so it's entirely possible that we could come out of that door somehow. I'm not sure how that would work. Instead, I'm gonna, like, screw myself somehow. I don't know how that happened. Oh, that's okay. Let's go down. We came through this door. Wait, there's no way to go down. Never mind! Alright, well, let's figure out what the secret is here. Oh, wait a minute. There's another turny thing down here. Does it just turn the... Oh, I see. It turns the middle block. Okay. So how does that help me at all? Oh, I guess... Okay, I need to match them up. So let's check this. This is kind of a trial and error kind of thing, though, which I'm not too happy about. I'm not a big fan of trial and error, just because... I mean, I like trial and error, the concept, but having it in a video game is kind of a pain in my ass, because now I got to figure out which side is which. And I'm still going to have to, like, jump down and figure out... Oh, I'm sorry, Fez. Sorry, not sorry. Let's jump down here, and we'll turn this around again. Aha! Says the blind man, as he took out his hammer and opened the door with a hammer. What? Even I'm confused about what I'm saying now. All right. Send me up. Oh, yeah, okay, I was waiting for that to happen, and it didn't happen, and it didn't happen, and it didn't happen, and then it happened. Launch me as high as I can go. Oh, it's cool. It reminds me of the... Ooh, it reminds me of the big tree with the mushroom. Launch me. Oh, yeah. All right, we'll go on the other side. It looks like I was climbing up behind this. That's cool that you could just do that in the background. I like that. All right, and this should take me up to where that cube was at the top. Oh, and there's a freaking sign that says something. I really need to know what the alphabet is so I can read these signs. That'll help me with most of the puzzles that I couldn't figure out, you know what I mean? And yes, one step closer to being mankind. We only need three more cubes in order to 100% the game. Oh, I don't want to go through that. I mean, I do want to go through that, but I don't want to go through that because there's more than meets the eye here. There's more than meets the eye to this level. I mean, I guess, I wonder if it just takes me back here. If it just takes me back there, it's fine. But the problem is that there's a locked door in here that I don't have a key for. And there's that as well. Yeah, I guess I'll just take the portal back. That makes more sense. Oh, actually, at this point, it would actually be better to go back, I think. Well, let's go back up inside here. We'll just take the portal back because I feel like that'll be... I don't know if easier is the word, but we'll take the portal back to the hub and we'll go from there. Because there's still a bunch of stuff that we need to look at here. I like how it marks off everything. I know I've talked about that before, but I wanted to bring it up again because I really like how it marks everything off as you go along. And it makes sure that you know which rooms you've already gotten stuff in. Because that makes way more sense than what I thought it was at the beginning, which was just throw you in and, oh, there's a bunch of hidden stuff that you don't know how to get. Teleportation! Whoa! Where does it go? I don't know if it's going to take us back to the hub or if it's going to take us back somewhere else or what. Because this doesn't look like the hub. This looks like a completely different place. Oh, okay, it is. Yeah, this is where we were at. All right, okay, well, if that's the case, then let's go through this door here since we haven't gone through it yet. And see if we can't find more things. I just love how happy he looks. He's so happy. Oh, and this is just a random cube. Does that mean I've finished this room? Okay, that was easy. I'll take it. It looks like that. Wait a minute. There's something in there. There's a shortcut. So this room has more. Yeah, there's a shortcut here. Where does this go to? So, somebody pointed out in the comments, oh, it goes into here, but I've done everything down in here, so I don't need to be down here. That's that one. We found that, and I was like, what do we do? And I'm like, it must be a shortcut. Turns out, totally is a shortcut, and now we know where it leads to. So if we ever needed to go back to the... Where does this go? Because I'm curious about this, too, because if this goes to someplace that I've never been to... Oh, have I been here before? Oh, this just takes us to the hubby hub of the hub, but like the top of the sewers, where the Mario pipe is. Choo choo choo. All right, what else is in here? There's another room. There's another room off of that branch there, so it's on this side somewhere. But then there's another room there too, and I haven't done everything in this room yet because there's a treasure chest here apparently. So, yeah, I don't even know, man. I don't even know, man. Let's keep going down a little bit and see if there's... Wait, hang on. Let's look on this side. No, this side. Yeah, there's the door. That's the door I'm looking for. That's the door I'm looking for. I really need to find a key, and it could be in that chest that's in that other hub room. There could be a key in there, because usually keys are only in chests, right? You can't find keys outside of chests, so it has to be in a chest. Although it could be a cube, as we have learned, that cubes can also be apparently in chests. And I'm okay with this. What in God's name? Why am I on the other side of the... That's not supposed to happen. Maybe it is supposed to happen. Oh, God. Come on, game. Why do you do this to me? I'm pretty sure that's a glitch again, and I might have to reset the game, but I'll reset the room first. That's one thing I've noticed. There's a couple, not game-breaking glitches, but there are ones that you have to reset the game in order to fix for some reason. I'm not sure why they do this. Oh, obviously, it's not intentional, but... It's highly, highly annoying. Because obviously I'm supposed to be able to grab this. Yeah, hang on. I'm going to reset the game real fast. Well, geez, there's a lot of crap up there. okay. What the balls, man? You saw what just happened. This game can be a little bit buggy. See? That worked just fine that time. But it wasn't working before. Sometimes with grabbing onto stuff, it just glitches and it forces you to reset the game. So that's an unfortunate happenstance, but that's okay. That's also one of my favorite words, by the way, happenstance, and I highly recommend that you use it in your everyday life, especially when talking about happenstances. Jump. Okay, this is going to do a thing. I'm just going to let this turn me. Turn, jump. No, jump. Fuck. this is not going well for me. I'm clearly very bad at this. This is going to fling me. Oh, man, I almost did that. I wasn't ready for the thing, though. There we go. Now I'm ready. I'm ready for science. This is gonna... Oh, man, this is gonna be really awkward. See, like, that's really awkward. Try this again. Jump. 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 Oh, that's not so bad, actually. Let's see if we can't get another cube. Although we are at the end of our time for this episode here, so I may call it an episode here. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Fez, and I will see you guys in the next episode where we'll make our way up this cool vertical level that we're in right now. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. We'll be right back.